Okay, so I'm going to try this at a much slower pace today. Yesterday I did a time lapse of this painting. This is about 45 minutes, and it went super fast in about 30 seconds. But this is just the first layer, and from this it gives me ideas to work from. For example, yesterday when I left it, the next thing that was coming to my mind was I was thinking I would like to start working with some coral. I love this pyrrole red with a little bit of white in it. It makes a really beautiful pink, and then with a little bit of yellow, it's a beautiful coral color. So that's what I was thinking, and maybe some black outlining. And that's all I've got right now. That's my next idea. I'll begin with that. I'll see where that leads me. I think I'm gonna go ahead and start with a few marks here that I'm beginning to see as maybe some pattern that I'd like to keep. I like this one over here. Those pinks might make some really nice little dots going down, circles going down this way. This is where I want to begin though. I want these corals. I know I want seafoam green because I love, that's one of my favorite colors. And I'm working with this hunter green. Let's just see where it goes, okay? So I've already mixed up a few colors here that I'm going to start with, and this is that pyrrole red. And I'm just going to paint, and you can watch. I mixed my colors. Ooh, I love this that's happening right now. This against this really light green is just... just a color that's kind of sticking in my mind right now, and I'll come back to that. And oh, and I love that little bit of teal that's in there, and I'm covering it up, but I do like that. I like the variety in the different pinks right now, so I'm kind of keeping a lot of things in mind as I go through. Back to this is a little bit deeper of that. And I like that too. It might be a little bit much, but that's okay. Let's kind of go with a few of those patterns I was talking about. I think a lot of people think abstracts, you just throw a bunch of paint on the canvas and yay, we're done. But really, there's a lot of thinking and thought that goes into where I'm going. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and go through a lot of this azo yellow. It's another color I really love. Totally lost the end on my brush there. That's what that only was, in case you're wondering. So I'm changing brushes here, and let's stick with some of this red. Ooh, I like that. I'm liking that area. Yesterday I was moving through this really fast. Today I'm slowing down now. It's starting to... That first layer is really... Actually, there's a lot of freedom in it. You can move really fast. You don't have to worry about anything coming together or working. Now I'm starting to kind of close in on it a little bit, and I'm thinking about what works, what doesn't, colors, combinations that I really like together. And I've really been after this kind of almost a salmon color, really loving it a lot. And once again, I really love that. That right there. Sometimes what happens to me though too is I'll love this and now it'll be really hard for me to go back and cover that up. And at some point I might need to. Okay. Let's paint. I think I'm gonna go ahead and go with some of this pink. Oops, sorry about that. Asked if I won't do some videos where you can watch me paint. So, this is it. Get to see. It's all an experiment. Really, even this videotaping right now, that's an experiment too. I'm not just really sure how that's going to work. If it doesn't work, I don't have to use it, right? Oh, and like that. Okay, let's just go with this here. Over the years, the way I started painting has changed. It's always changing, and I don't really think it matters how you start. It's just putting those first marks in, that's really what matters. Once you get past that, you're on your way to creating something very, very beautiful. This green, and I honestly don't know why, but that's what I'm thinking, so that's what I'll go ahead and do. A lot of times I will just mix my paints right on the canvas itself, and I don't really like that. I don't really like what happened right there, but it's okay. Never know how it's gonna work out later. This green. And then I think I really want to move back to my red again. And there's a lot of things going on here that I love. I love these textures, so I'm hoping to keep that. We'll see. Trying to get used to being watched while I'm painting, and although there's not a really live audience here, I know you were watching me, so so sure how long you would be interested in watching either, because as I said, this is much slower of a process than what I did yesterday when I laid down that first layer. I go through really pretty fast starting off. And as I move along like this, I'm building layers, and I'm really allowing the painting to talk to me, and I'm responding. I like this. Right now it says hello, so I'm gonna go talk to it for a little bit. And I this is one of my favorite colors. I mix it up myself. It's a thylo blue green shade. A little bit of, ooh, I like that. In fact, I love that. Okay, so how many times have you heard me say, oh, I love that color. I love this, I love that. I still really like this going on right here for some reason. But now I'm liking this against that. And whoops, a little paint splashed over here. Nice. Okay, as I'm building right now, what I'm noticing is there's some textures that are building up. For example, right here and right here, which are kind of standing out more, so that means I'm going to have to go back in on these areas beside there, it, and do some work with it. I'm not sure where this is going, and I'm kind of feeling this is going to be lighter areas, so why not? I'm going to go ahead and see if I can mix up a neutral, kind of a neutral off-white that has some of those colors that I just used, have been using, and on it, see a little bit of yellow, and lots of white. Sorry, this can actually get kind of a little boring as I'm off to the side mixing. Okay, I really like that. I'm like loving the contrast now. So I think I'm going to continue working with that light that I've mixed. I'm not too sure about what's going on here yet. Sometimes I really like the way that brush stroke laid down right there, so I think I want to try and just keep that area. Now I'm moving in on this.
this can get kind of boring, likely watching. It really does take some time. Most of the time. For everything, all the pieces to fall together. And I say most of the time, now and then I'll have a painting that just falls together, just like, you know, it's just magic. And what's in the blue moon? Is that a wrap? Okay. Lots going on here. Lots going on. So, we're going to have to figure out some things here. Okay. Next, I'm not. That is a problem area for me right now. So, that's going to be the next area to go to. Kind of like what's going on there with that color-wise, somewhat, not too far from it. Let's try this, let's see what happens. Ooh, getting pretty bright now. Imagine that. I can't seem to stay away from. Pretty bright, okay. Go with some of this blue. Okay. Kind of like that. This little square that's happening here. I just like the movement that's happening with this right here. Got my eye. Okay. I think over here, I'm gonna go over here. Oh, on the side like that. So it's just a continual, I'm kind of like that teal that's going on right there. So I'm gonna go ahead and pull out a teal that I already have mixed up and work with that just a tab, and I don't want it to be too intense. I don't feel like I have to. Okay, maybe in there. Just a tab. Okay, that's all I wanted of that. Now, this area is a problem, and so what are we going to do with that? I don't know. I really do not know, but I think we'll just start something here. So, I don't know what I'm doing. I am just searching. Let's try some more of that over here. I'm totally happy with that. Okay. So, what can be next? I'm going to think I go back to red for a little bit. Thank you. and I turn my paintings a lot while I'm working. It'll help to give me a new perspective here right away. What do I do with my towels? Okay, there they are. Okay, so let's go with a little bit more of this. It's a portrait pink. That, but let's try that with a little bit of yellow and see what happens. I'm just going to put a little yellow in here, and then I'm going to add some. I'm actually just mixing my paint right on the canvas, which I do that a lot. What's going on in here? Still kind of pretty chaotic over here. So let's see. Okay. Let's pull that together right there like that. Let's just move across the board. Something's happening. I'm not sure what it is yet, but something's happening. Let's go to this azo and see what we can do with that. This azo yellow. My brush has got some other colors in it, so it's not going to be exactly sometimes I feel like I'm adding more to the chaos than I am. I'm actually feeling like doing some marks here. So let's just do thank you. I can actually feel myself losing my whole perspective right now. I am just making decisions and I have no idea. At least that's the way it feels as to what it looks like. Probably just need to go ahead and stop it right here. I could go ahead and turn it around and look at it that way for just a second before I quit. I actually think I kind of liked it better the other way, and I don't know why. Don't know why, but. I'm gonna go with that a while longer. And I kinda like to do some more white into it. I don't know. Did I say I was gonna stop? I probably should. Or should I just go ahead and stop? Part of me is really trying to get focus, and then a part of me is thinking about that camera up there, which I enjoy watching other artists paint and seeing their process, so I'm just trying to share a little bit, but it is hard for me to, I like the, so, I love that contrast thing that's going on between some whites. So, thinking through, I like that. I'm not so sure about that. I'm loving this and this and this. I really love this area over here. This is going to be some more work. I like this over here. So, those are all decisions that I am making. I like the kind of like the little patterns of dots, which it may be too soon yet to start in on. Those are kind of things I say for the, those are details that can help pull the eye across, like continuation of little dots going across there. I might find something over here. Here's some I could do. Usually these are for me the last thing. Bye.
Maybe I'm done, huh?
I might surprise myself. Okay, that, I like that. It almost looks like a little rose over here. What about this over here? Can we do something with that? Let's see. I kind of feel like that line needs to overlap onto this one, but that paint is still wet, so I'm gonna let that dry. That is still definitely talking to me right there. I don't know if I can do something right now. I'm needing to really stop, but it's just, let me see what we can do. I'm usually good for about an hour painting. At the most, I might go 2 hours, but I'm usually good for about an hour. And I do paint pretty fast, so quickly making decisions. So I get a lot done, but I kind of need to just get away from it, stop, see what's going on. I don't know, this whole thing here is just something that I'm really liking. That is causing me some problems right in there and that. But I may come back and find that, hey, I really love that area. I really love that area. Alright. That's it. I think I'm just gonna let that go and let it rest a little bit, and I'll come back and do another session on it. I hope you enjoyed that. Thank you for watching.